I'm pretty sure you're all aware of the poor performance of Russian tanks in Ukraine, and the reasons for such performance are numerous. From the poor tactics to the inadequate protection, we have seen it all. But could they have prevented this? Of course, the obvious answer would be to just use the tanks better, train the crew better, train the units better, and so on. But they could have solved all of those problems by just adopting an active protection system. This would of course not solve all the problems, but it would give more ground for error. And I know what some of you are thinking. Oh, their tanks have active protection systems already. T-90 has Shtora, and we have seen T-ATU with Drozd being destroyed. However, the Shtora system of T-90 is a soft kill active protection system, and on top of that, barely even works against the modern threats. Shtora consists of Dazzlers and laser warning receivers. Dazzlers are used to disrupt Sackloth's ATGMs, but only work against older ones, and on top of that, the crew needs to spot a missile in order to utilize the Dazzlers, because the system cannot detect Sackloth's guided ATGMs. Laser warning receivers are there to warn the crew when the tank is being lased by laser rangefinders or some laser-guided missiles, but that is all they do, warn the crew. The crew can then decide what to do with the information, although they can set the system to automatically pop smoke when it detects a laser. The laser warning receivers are also installed on the T-90M. And about that T-80, well, Drozd hasn't been made in decades, and all of the more modern pictures of the tank have the cassettes empty, which most likely means that it didn't even work because the parts and everything that was made to keep it running hasn't been produced in decades. You see, back in the good olden days of the USSR, they produced hundreds of Drozd active protection systems, and if they had such capacity now, we would be seeing a different story. But since the collapse of USSR, it became apparent that the hard kill active protection systems would be extremely rare if they were adopted in the first place, but of course that would never happen. There was the famous T-ATUM with Arena active protection system, but it was just a test vehicle and was never put into service. But there has been so much propaganda from the Russian side about the vehicle that many believe that Russians actually adopted that active protection system, but they obviously never have. Russians, instead of trying to develop an active protection system for their tanks, decided to go to the old days of pumping out mediocre tanks in greater numbers, which is evident by the number of T-72B3 tanks they have produced. The first tank we have actually seen in recent history with an actual active protection system is the T-14 Armata with its Afghanit active protection system. The system has launchers mounted on the sides of the turret, covering the frontal 180 degrees, intended to intercept AT threats. The system can also detect IR signature of missiles and deploy IR smoke to mask the tank's thermal signature. It even has the smoke launchers at the top, which would protect it against Javelin, because Javelin uses thermal signature of the target to guide the missile. But of course, T-14 is still not in active service, and is, after 7 years, still in testing phase. A couple of years ago, Russians presented the improved Arena hardkill active protection system called Arena-M. This system is said to be able to be installed on every Russian tank in active service, including T-72B3 and T-90M tanks, which, if you haven't figured out so far, do not have any hard kill active protection system. They announced that this system will become available starting from 2025, but knowing them, I do have some doubts about that. Keep in mind though that the US and Germany are already installing hard kill active protection systems on their tanks. There are probably hundreds of Abrams tanks with Trophy right now, and the Russians haven't even started yet. And now, with most of their casualties in the war being from anti-tank rockets and missiles, it is more than apparent that the hard kill active protection system is required as soon as possible, and it must offer top attack protection as well. It should also be noted that the massive majority of Russian tanks are lacking panoramic sight with thermal vision for the commander and rely on old sights from the 70s for the observation of the commander. Most of those sights are not even stabilized, and have very limited field of view and have an obvious weakness of lacking thermals, which all modern NATO tanks have. Commander's Independent Thermal Viewer, or CITV as those sights are called, would also greatly improve their survivability because chances of spotting the enemy would be much greater. The only tank in active service to have a CITV is T-90M. T-14 also has one, but it's not in active service. If Russians focused on developing a hard-kill active protection system many years ago, their current performance would not yield so many casualties. But, of course, such systems require money and time to be produced. But back in the USSR, they were pumping out DROZD systems in pretty decent numbers. If they haven't given up on it and actually improved upon the system, we would be seeing something completely different today. That would be all. If you like my content, you can consider supporting me on Patreon. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Have a nice day.